All right, Shalom, Yashar Allah, peace, Israel. First and foremost, as always, we want to give our praises and honor and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushua, Ba'ashem, Kapadash. Double honor to our elders, apostles, our great messengers, James, worldwide, and our peace and blessings to the hopefully like Akiam out there laboring in this ministry, pushing this gospel all across the globe in righteousness, in sincerity, and truth. And also, Shalom, to the Akiam, Wa'akwaf, peace and blessings to the brothers and sisters that may be tuning and listen, studying under the vibration of Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahushua. Yahweh, that's the Hebrew name of whom the world is going to call God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Yahweh means He is, He to be, He exists, the being that existed before time, also known as the Shadow of Days. And Yahweh Shach HaMashiach, that's the Hebrew name of His beloved Son, whom the world is going to call Jesus Christ. Yahweh Shah means He who saved, He who deliver, the Savior of the elect of the nation of Israel. Bahasham, Baha, which means in the Sham name, will call Spirit Kadash, holy, in the name of the Holy Spirit, which pretty much allow us to be able to understand the scriptures. This is in the Paleo Hebrew, the ancient Hebrew, the Lashon Kodash, the Holy Tongue, the language of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and ultimately the language of the children of Israel. And once again, to Wadi Abashim Mashiach for allowing us to be able to understand this wonderful gospel. I'm Banu War.
Tazu War.
With two brethren here from the GMS Boston, linking up to do a short lesson on Lord willing to the Spirit of Abashim Mashiach, Lord willing, certifying. Just want to go over this article real quick, you know, because ever since this pandemic, you know, the rich are getting richer and the poor are getting poorer. This pandemic was a perfect opportunity used by the elite to pretty much cut off the middle class, to get rid of the middle class, right? Because we bring it out always, because once this devil implement the RFID microchip, which is indeed the mark of the beast, there won't be no middle class. It's either you're gonna be poor or rich, man. And that's exactly what it is. And the people that most affected by this pandemics are you so-called Black Hispanics and Americans. You know, we don't have anything in this place, you know what I'm saying? We mainly rely on this on Esau for everything, as the crisis says, you know what I'm saying? So pretty much, man, this pandemic, like I said before, it was a perfect ways for this elite to take full advantage of the situation. The rich are getting richer and the poor are getting poorer, you know, ever since this pandemic started, right? Small stores like your mom and your pop store, right? Mm-hmm. They were closed. They were not allowed to take advantage of the economy. Meanwhile, you have big major corporations such as Walmart, Amazon,
Target.
Mm-hmm. Target, right? They were allowed to open. And this devil, what's that devil name? Jeff Bezos. He became a billionaire
during this pandemic,
you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Meanwhile, you have your regular people are struggling. That's mm-hmm. exactly what it is. That's a perfect way this devil used as a way to cut off the middle class. Right?
That's right. So you want to get into the article?
Yeah, quick. Come on.
All right, this is from ZeroHedge.com. The headline reads, greatest rise in equality. Inequality, Salake, ever. Mm-hmm. The last 6 months saw sharpest rise in the U.S. poverty in half a century.
Mm-hmm.
A new poverty estimate seeking to analyze the nationwide impact of government relief measures, which expired just at the end of the last month, has found that the latter half of 2020 marked the sharpest rise in the U.S. poverty rate since the 1960s.
Yeah, you know, we all can agree that 2020 had been a chaotic year. You know what I'm saying? You know, it's a beautiful year for us. You know, because Elder Apostle Tahar coined the year to be was the year of
prophecy in 2020.
2020, and so many prophecy actually came to pass, man.
That's right.
You know, and that's exactly what it is, man. The Murph has been gone to this in this place, man. This place is finished, man. You know, and Esau pretty much used lies, deception, and deceit to seize control, to steal the resources of the earth, man. That's how this devil has always been getting down, you know, by lying, deceiving, and that's how he stole the control of the earth, you know.
Kind of got a quick precept, Ecclesiastes 12, verse 1. Remember now the Creator in the days of thy youth,
mm-hmm.
while the evil days come not, nor the years draw nigh, when thou shalt say, I have no pleasure in them.
Mm-hmm.
While the sun, or the light, or the moon, or the stars be not darkened, nor the clouds return after the rain, in the day when the keepers of the house shall tremble, and the strong men shall bow themselves, and the grinders cease because they are few, and those that look out of the windows be darkened, and the doors shall be shut in the streets when the sound of the grinding is low, and he shall rise up at the voice of the bird, and all the daughters of music shall be brought low.
And that's exactly what's currently happening. You have a store apocalypse. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Major corporation stores are pretty much shutting
down
the door altogether because they see there is no future. And that's exactly why ESO is trying to come up with stimulus packages to pretty much keep the economy going. That's exactly what it is. The economy is finished, man. And pretty soon, man, by these devils printing money out of nowhere, you know, because the money itself is worthless. It doesn't back by neither silver nor gold.
Yeah.
So it's a piece of paper.
It's devaluing.
By them printing money like never seen before. That's going to cause hyperinflation. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, right.
The price of the goods going to rise. Meanwhile, the dollar going to go down.
Yep,
you know what I'm saying?
Right.
That's exactly what's coming, man. So this place is finished, man. You know, while the sun or the moon be darkened, right?
Yep. Oh, while the sun or the light or the moon or the stars mm-hmm. be not darkened,
mm-hmm.
nor the clouds return after the rain,
mm-hmm.
in the day when the keepers of the house shall tremble.
Yeah, come, the keepers of the house are those financial analysts, those are the Wall Street guys, those that pretty much watch for the economy. They are trembling because they see that the collapse of the system is inevitable. The collapse of the economy is inevitable. It's going to come. And they pretty much says 1930s was the Great Depression,
mm-hmm.
what's about to take place, pretty much gonna make the Great Depression looks like a playground, man.
That's right. And and it's gonna only lead to more evictions, more people with jobless, you know, more people are gonna be suffering and going through pain, and actually it's gonna cause more chaos, rioting, looters, you know. People are going to start taking matters in their own hands because, hey, they don't have the financial or the money to make ends meet.
Yeah.
So once their back's against the wall, and let's say, you know, they have no money for food and their ribs are touching, hey, it's going to be a dog-eat-dog world. And this is what we've been prophesying, that, hey, all total chaos and tribulation is coming to America, man, that great city Babylon, man. It lived deliciously for years and years, but now it's time to reap what it sowed. The
mm-hmm.
Lord is now about to judge this place, and we're about to see the downfall here in Babylon the Great, a.k.a. America, man.
John, matter of fact, can I back you up, bro? This Isaiah 24, verse 7, the new wine mourneth, the divine language, or the merry heart do sign,
mm-hmm.
the mirth of Tabor sees, the noise of them that we just ended, the joys of the harp ceased. They shall not drink wine with songs. Strong drink shall be bitter to them that drink it. The city of confusion is broken down. Every house is shut up that no man may come in.
That's right. The mirth of this place is down ever since this COVID. You know, everything's been shut down, whether it's your nightlife, your sporting events, some gyms, bars, most restaurants. Everything's been brought down, you know. This place is now seeing, starting to turn into a third world country.
That's right.
You know, it's in the beginnings of it. You know, the mirth is gone. People are now are going through more suffering. There's more divorce rates. There's more suicide rates coming now because of this whole pandemic and no jobs and, you know, more people in poverty. Again, it's just only going to cause hysteria, chaos in America, man. And then you're going to start seeing people rioting again, invading stores, invading one another for food and goods just for survival, man.
That's
and
right.
This is what this is part of the sword and the plague that the Lord is going to bring on the earth, man.
That's right. That's right. And it says, there's a crying for wine in the streets. All joy is darkened.
Mm-hmm.
The mirth of the land is gone.
There's a cry for wine in the streets, man. That wine is the philosophy, the truth, man. There's going to be a cry for what's going on. Why is all this happening? But the Lord has his servants, the prophets, been giving warning. We've been telling you for times like this, but the Israelites, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, you know, they don't want to take heed. They really think that, you know, this place might come back and get a reboot, get back into healing and being united and actually getting restored, instead of listening to the servants, the prophets, and actually seeking the Lord, man. This is all the will of the Heavenly Father. He is putting this place. He's shutting the mouth for this place. He is bringing the spirit of war and hate in America, man. That's why everything is divided now.
Huh.
You know, this is, we can see the times of trouble that are in hand. But again, our people don't take heed, man. They're just caught up in the distractions of the world, man.
Yeah, that's right. Come, even domestic violence is at an all time high, man.
That's right.
No, that's how you know this is it, man. This place is finished.
That's right.
It's Ezekiel 7:3. Now is the end come upon thee, and I will send my anger upon thee, and will judge thee according to thy ways, and will recompense upon thee all thy abomination. And mine eye shall not spare thee, neither will I have pity, but I will recompense thy ways. So like, but I will recompense thy ways upon thee, and thy abomination shall be in the midst of thee, and ye shall know that I am the Lord Yahweh Shemeshai. Thus saith the Lord, power and evil and only evil, behold, it is come.
That's right, keep going.
Verse 6, and end is come, the end is come, it watcheth for thee, behold, it is come.
Come, one more.
The morning is gone, the morning is come up unto thee, O thou that dwellest in the land, the time is come, the day of trouble is near, and not the sounding again of the mountain.
Okay, so the end is come, the days of trouble are now at hand. You know, again, the Lord said he was going to bring Jacob's trouble upon the four corners of the earth, you know, but mainly here in America, because this place, the Lord has an indignation he's furious with this place. What's that in Hosea 4:1?
Yeah, you can't remember.
Real quick, you know what I mean? Because the Lord is furious with America, man, because again, like in other lessons that we have done, and multiple brothers and even the apostles have said it in their lessons, hey, America is the cesspool, is the nucleus of all the wickedness that goes forth throughout the earth.
That's
so
right.
Now it's time to receive the judgment of the Heavenly Father. That big bad bully is going to have to be, he's going to have to reap what he sowed, man.
Come on, this is Hosea 4:1.
That's right.
Hear the word of the Lord, ye children of Israel, that's for the right. Lord had a controversy with the inhabitants of the land, because there was no truth, no mercy, no knowledge of the Most High in the land. By swearing and lying and killing and stealing and committing adultery, they break out in blood touch of blood.
That's right. Hey, hear the word of the Lord, ye children of Israel. Again, this goes out for you Israelites, man. We are constantly giving this warning for you Israelites to get right and repent, man. There's no need to trust in America or hope for this place to get back to greatness or restored, because this is the will of the Heavenly Father that this place gets destroyed, man.
Yeah.
So if you guys, it behooves you Israelites to get right, or if you're not, you're going to receive the same judgment as America and these heathens, man.
Yeah, because ultimately, This is a cesspool of wickedness. This is the power seat of Esau. That's where this devil's seat, you know, pretty much is, as his power structure. That's where he pretty much governed the whole world, putting out his lies, deception over the whole earth, man.
This
place has to be pretty much taken down before the kingdom can be established. Because we always bring it out. 2 Ezra 6:9 says, for Esau is the end of the world, and Jacob is the beginning of it that followeth. So ultimately, two kings cannot be sitting in the same throne. Before the kingdom can be established, America has to go down, man.
That's right. You know what I'm saying? That's right. And this is why you see poverty at an all-time rate. You see, like the brother mentioned, domestic violence. You see more divorces. You see more suicides happening now ever since this whole the Crown 19, is because that's the Lord bringing the plagues, bringing that hate and war spirit, man. This, we at the time of his downfall, man, and blesses our eyes that we can see it, man.
That's right.
We can see it. There's no way that, you know, that Esau can give out stimulus packages or sign more orders or what do you call it, decrees or anything, just to try to restore America. This place is fit for destruction, and we at the end, like the brother read out, the end is come. And sure, now you're gonna see more evil grow upon the earth. I got a quick piece of
you got it, we got it.
2 Ezra 16, I'll start at verse 19. Matter of fact, I'll start at verse 17. Woe is me, who will deliver me in those days? The beginning of sorrows and great mourning, the beginning of famine and great death, the beginning of wars, and the powers shall stand in fear.
Yeah, because if I may, I real quick, right? Because the Lord gonna allow his the angels, right? When you read Revelation, the 7th chapter, This says, Lord says, give the angel a command to hold forth the four winds of destruction.
Yep.
So once the elect is here, guess what? The Lord gonna allow the angels to pretty much unleash all hell, man.
That's right.
All hell is about to break loose, and pretty much that's our message, man. Before it can get better, it had to get worse, man.
That's right.
You know?
That's right. And that's them plagues. It's going to be sorrows, the great mourning, the famine. I'll read it again. The beginning of sorrows, great mourning, the beginning of famine and great death, the beginning of wars and powers shall stand in fear, the beginning of evils. What shall I do when these evils shall come?
Yeah, evil.
Bad times.
That's what's coming. Or times such as never was since there was a nation, man. So what you're about to witness here in America, in the whole world, right, it's something that you never seen before, man.
That's right.
You know, plagues, man, all kind of plagues, all kind of famine of biblical proportion. You know what I'm saying? You know,
great misery,
man. You know, newly created creatures, man.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
Con, verse 19, behold, famine and plague, tribulation and anguish are sent as scourges for amendment. But for all these things they shall not turn from their wickedness, nor be always mindful of the scourges. Behold, victuals shall be so good cheap upon earth that they shall think themselves to be in good case, and even then shall evils grow upon the earth, the sword, famine, and great confusion.
Yeah, victuals shall be so good cheap upon the earth that they shall think themselves to be in good case. Right now, Esau is giving out stimulus packages, trying to repair the economy. You know, people seems to they have this idea that America will bounce back. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Just like Donald Trump, he wanted to make America great again. Now this devil, Joe Biden, he pretty much come in the same mind frame. He wants to pretty much
like he's gonna be the hero.
The hero, you know what I'm saying?
The healer.
The credit for, you know, the credit for bringing America back to its normal state and pretty much how it used to be before. You know what I'm
That's
saying?
Right.
You know, but we know ultimately, the scripture says, "For when they shall say peace and safety, then sudden destruction
fall up upon them.
Come upon you." So pretty much when you think this place is going to bounce back, guess what? The Lord going to unleash all hell, man.
That's right.
You know?
That's what it says. For many great evils then shall grow upon the earth, man.
That's right.
And that's with all the things that we mentioned, you know, the plagues, the pestilence, the wars, the fighting, you know, the civil unrest. You know, when Esau showing his horns, coming down with great wrath, man. You Israelites, again, because this word, this warning, this lesson is for you Israelites pretty much to get right, to come out of the mindset or the philosophies of Esau, Edom, and Babylon the Great, man. You're supposed to forsake this place spiritually and mentally, you know, and you're supposed to look and pray and hasten to your power, which is Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. He's the one that's going to be your deliverance. He's the one that's going to take care of you. He's the one that's going to heal you, heal your soul, instead of, you know, giving you things that's vain and worthless, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I got Jeremiah 51. I'll start at verse 6. Flee out of the midst of Babylon and deliver every man his soul. Be not cut off in her iniquity, for this is the time of the Lord's vengeance. He will render unto her a recompense.
Yeah, the flee is is a mental flee. You know what I'm saying? Come out of her ways, you know, her philosophy, her ideas, right?
That's right.
Because this place is polluted, it shall destroy you even with such destruction. Romans 15 verse 4, be transformed by the renewing of your mind. It's pretty much
Romans 12:2.
12:2, right?
Yep.
Be not conformed to this world,
yeah,
but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. So pretty much let go of this devil's ways, you know what I'm saying?
That's right.
Because we have something way better that's coming to us, you know.
That's right. Verse 7, Babylon had been a golden cup in the Lord's hand that made all the earth drunken. The nations have drunken of her wine, therefore the nations are mad. Babylon is suddenly fallen and destroyed. How for her take balm for her pain? If so, be she may be healed. We would have healed Babylon, but she is not healed. Forsake her and let us go every one into his own country. For her judgment reaches into the heaven and is lifted up even in the skies.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is. The mindset of the Edomites is pretty much to build back better. Yahweh Bashem says, they shall build, but I will throw down. So it doesn't matter what your purpose is, how many laws and legislation that you're trying to come up with to heal this place. Guess what? Ultimately, it's going to be done away with, because that's the will of Yahweh Bashem Mashiach.
That's right. Yep, Babylon is suddenly falling. See, that's the will of the Heavenly Father. There's no coming back. Like we said, it's only going to get worse from here on out, man. You know, there's no way that this place is going to establish their economy. Everything, everybody's going to live fluently and happy, and there's going to be no more racial tension, and everybody's going to be starting up businesses and, you know, investing in stocks and becoming millionaires. You know what I'm saying? Mm. It's over, man. This economy, this way of life, it's over. Spiritually, mentally, you know. But now, well soon, is going to be thrown down and fallen physically. And we know that by the plagues that the Lord is going to bring on the earth. And then the icing on the cake is them thermonuclear missiles that's going to be shot off from Armageddon or World War III.
Yeah. You know? Matter of fact, let me go to our article real quick. I have one more paragraph to go into, right?
Yeah.
It says that this amount to additional 8 million Americans being considered newly poor nearly double the highest annual increase in poverty in over a half century. The study author, economist Bruce Mayer of the University of Chicago and James Sullivan of the University of Notre Dame further found that Black Americans were among the hardest hit in more than twice as likely to fall below the poverty line as white Americans.
That's right. See, so you could see that it's this pandemic, this poverty, this poverty is really hitting you Jakes, man. They say Black Americans, you know, we know that as the tribe of Judah,
yeah.
You know, and it could be the so-called Haitians, you know, the Levites, the so-called Benjamites. But we know it's also affecting the so-called brown communities as well.
That's right.
So Latinos,
Native Americans.
And Native Americans, man. So this is why, again, we give you these warnings and we give you articles because it's for you Israelites. This word is for you Israelites, for you to seek the Lord while he may be found and repent. And ask for your Lord and your Savior to deliver you and to protect you in these times, man. Don't trust in your oppressors. Just trust in the Lord, man.
That's right.
Because he's your power only, man. He's your army. He is your comforter, you know?
Mm-hmm.
He's your shield and butler, as the scripture says, man.
This is a matter of fact, it's Ecclesiastes 10, verse 4. The power of the earth is in the hand of the Lord, and in due time he will set over it one that is profitable.
That's right. So we know. The ones that's running the world is set up through the Heavenly Father. He has the power to put up the basis of men, as according to Daniel's. Was that 4 and 12?
4 and 17.
That's right. But yeah, we just know that right now Esau, Edom is in power, not off his own might, off his own strength. It's because the Lord put him there. And he used our enemy to be to oppress us, for us to learn our lesson, because we actually sinned against the Most High. So that's our punishment. But again, we know, as the prophecy says, for Esau is the end of the world and Jacob is the beginning of it that follows. So now we at the end of Esau's rulership, and the Lord is going to set up him that is profitable, which is the Lord and his servants, the prophets and the Israelites, the elect. You know, we're going to be ruling forever and ever with righteousness. We don't have to worry in our kingdom. We don't have to worry about unemployment, worry about poverty, people not eating. No, everybody's going to be taken care of in a righteous way.
That's right.
Because when the righteous are authority, people rejoice. But when the wicked bear rule, people are mourning.
That's
and right now, we're in the time of mourning because the wicked can't do right.
That's right.
He's coming up with ways and policies to destroy nations, to destroy the household.
To oppress you.
To oppress you.
To make life even harder for you as it is.
So this is why he needs to be removed. Constantly, we say the so-called white man, and not all white people, mind you, it's just the Edomites. They go back to the line of Esau, Edom.
Right.
They're the cancer of the earth. They need to be removed from power because the Lord made them as the wicked. You know,
right.
their role is to cause chaos and evil and distress throughout all nations, man.
This is Ecclesiastes 10 and 8. Because of unrighteous dealings,
right,
injuries, and riches got by deceit, the kingdom is translated from one people to another. And pretty much the article speaks for itself, man. We break it out at the beginning that this pandemic was a perfect weapon to pretty much cut off the middle class.
That's right.
That's how Esau used it. He uses lie, deception, deceit to pretty much oppress our people even more, man.
Yeah, he ain't playing fair. He rigged the game.
That's right.
That's why he has to be removed. Now he's being found out. The son of perdition is being revealed. His skirt is being lifted. People are starting to know that he's the damn devil. And now he's trying to come up with ways and policies and laws to try to keep his little little power or hegemony still living. But hey, he can't fight against the will of the Heavenly Father. We at the time to seeing the end of his rulership, man. So
right.
Blesses our eyes because we could see it. And we're trying, through the spirit power, Yahweh Shem Al-Shah, to those that's watching or listening, we're trying to open up your eyes through the Lord to see it as well, man.
Yeah,
but we at the downfall. We at the end of this kingdom, man.
That's right, come. So, hey, that was a quick lesson.
That's right.
We hope this was edifying.
Mm-hmm.
So we want to give our praises and honor and glory to
Yahweh
Ba'ashim, Yahushua Ba'ashim, Kakadash. Double honor to our elders, apostles, our great Melson, James, all what. And on peace and blessings to the hopefully that like I came out there laboring in this ministry, pushing this gospel all across the globe in righteousness, in sincerity, and in truth. Until next time, shalom.
Shalom.
Abad babar.
Abad babar.